What up, guys? It's Captain Rose Productions 72, and welcome to Figure Friday, episode 66, or Order 66. And today we're doing R2-D2 from 1989, and, well, this is going to be one of those longer episodes, not because of minifigure detail or anything like that. This one was in way too many sets, and I'm going to have to edit all of those ones in and say their numbers, so this one's a lot. So this is one of those common minifigures. He was in sets from 1989 to 2008, so he stuck around a lot longer than most of the original minifigures did. Because within that first, you know, he was there for 9 years. Within that first 9 years, a lot of characters got updated. Like, the first few years, they were all like, yeah, well, then they got the skin tone. And he's one of those few figures that didn't, you know, get any upgrades from that. He did get upgraded in 2008 in the Death Star. And we've had a couple of versions of since then, including a Clone Wars version. And I think there's a Dagobah version that came out a couple years ago. I am not too sure. But yeah, this is a really cool minifigure that I do enjoy. I have quite a few of him. I got one for Christmas 1 year, like, separately. Because I asked for that figure. I got him in the 2006 X-Men. I got him in the Twilight. I got him in the Anakin Starfighter. So that's, yeah, that's all of them. He's in quite a few sets, this one. And it probably won't be the last of this version. For instance, I have two of the more modern version. And I have one of the, you know, the one in between that. It was in, like, the Death Star, Battle of Endor and stuff. So, yeah, time to read out these set numbers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read them all out. And then I'm going to put a slideshow of all of the sets pictures up. Now, they're not in any particular order, but the order you see the pictures will have been in the order that I'm reading them now. So after I'm done reading these, it will pop up and you guys will get to see all of those sets that he's in. So he was in set 7171. Set 4475, set 7141, set 7660, set 10144, he was in set 7669, he was in set 7680, 7190, 7140, 7191, 4502, 6212, and finally 7106. That is 13 sets he was in from 1999 to 2008. That was a mouthful. So I do know what some of those sets are, like 10144 to Sandcrawler, 7106 is like a droid escape pod. I know a few of them, but I wasn't going to say the sets, because the way I had to get this information was in the book that I use for most of these. R2-D2 from that year just says see set information, like, it's not next to the minifigure, it just says 1999 to 2008, which makes it slightly difficult. But now, before I show you the minifigure, here's all the sets he was in the order that I just said them. Enjoy. That is all the sets that he was in. There was quite a few, and there's even a few I didn't know he was in. Like, I knew he was in some sets. It was, some of them were obvious to me, but some weren't. So that's a learning experience for both me and those of you who didn't know. So this minifigure's basic. Like, obviously the video's a bit long because I had to show you all that. But in terms of the figure itself, there isn't much. 1999, it was a good attempt. I mean, obviously we've kept the same mould around. I'm just gonna zoom in, let you guys see better. So obviously we've kept the same mold about all these years. I don't think they're ever going to change that. Obviously, the one thing he's missing that all R2-D2s or all astromechs are missing is the third leg. Oh, and I nearly broke my thing there that I use for so many figs. The torso for 1999, I think, is brilliant. Like, they definitely got that right. One thing we still don't have 21 years later is back printing on the back of, like, the cylindrical piece that is his body. Obviously, the back of the head has always had it, as you can tell with this being the first version. So the head printing is probably the first thing you'll notice that seems a bit off. It doesn't come down all the way. This was a thing until 2008. 2008 was the year that they managed to fix this on all astromech droids. That is when they got it right. So, as far as I believe, I've not actually looked into it, but from what I have heard, this is due to the way the heads were printed back then. And it took them a while to get it right, because the printing would be too small, and trying to put it over that space. And I've seen pictures of them try to do the whole head back then, and it doesn't look great. But, nowadays, obviously, we have the different versions. What I'm going to do is I'm going to twirl it around a little bit more, and then I'm going to get out the 2008 R2-D2 and the most recent version of R2-D2 just to let you guys see the difference over the last sort of 12 years since this guy has been away. So, I'm about to show you guys the other two versions right there. Okay, then, it's not the best way to show them all, but do you know what? I'll probably have to zoom out to show them like when I'm turning it. But yeah, obviously there's a few versions of R2-D2 in there that I don't have. For instance, I don't have the 2009 Clone Wars one from Anakin's Y-Wing. And obviously there's like the one with the drinks tray, but I'm just talking like main versions, like movie versions of R2-D2, which is what all of these are. So obviously you can see difference between them as they get on and on. Like the biggest change would have been the 2008, to go for the full dome and have it all in the right colour and all the little prints that are in their minds is a bit bad on the prints there. Obviously with age I got that minifigure from the land speeder from 10 years ago, but you guys can see the difference. Also I don't need to, zoom out to twirl it around, but yeah, you guys can see the difference between all of these minifigures. They're all very cool minifigures and they're all ones that I love to have in my collection. But yeah, all the molds and all that sort of thing has stayed the same over the last 21 years, and it probably won't change unless in a few years down the line they say, hey, let's give it that third leg. Although it's quite easy to give the third leg. I might do a tutorial video on it. I don't know, there's a video idea. But yeah, now on to the 1999 R2-D2 final thoughts and end of the video. Gonna move him there slightly. So my final thoughts, well, if you guys are not new to the channel, you guys have been watching for a while, for those of you who are new to the channel, this is a common occurrence with me of old minifigures. The nostalgia part of this minifigure, like the coolness of it, the fact that it was in the Lego games and stuff, makes me want to say this is the best version and my favourite version. When in reality, at least for me, the best version was probably 2008 R2-D2, the one that I just showed you that was in the Death Star, Luke's land speeder and all those sets. It's probably the coolest looking version. I do like the modern one, but personally for me, because I wasn't alive when this minifigure came out, I'm only 17, so the one that was out when I was younger was the 2008 R2-D2, which was there till 2013, and also in 2014 they came out with that new version. So on, this is a really cool minifigure. I do like it, but it's not one that I would use in mocks unless I was doing like a mock that had all the vintage minifigures in it, which, there's another idea. But yeah, I did enjoy doing this, and it's one of those minifigures that I have a fondness for, and I do quite like it. And I'm pretty sure this is the first time we have done, apart from Rot of the Hutt, I'm sure, yeah, we did Rot of the Hutt and Jabba the Hutt. This is the only non-regular minifigure that I've shown on here, so it's a first. So yeah, I'm just gonna get the next episode and let you guys know who we're looking at next week. Next week's episode is another is a favourite. From 2009, was in the DK exclusive Lego Star Wars book. Comment the timestamp and guess what minifigure this is, because it can only be one minifigure. And we're looking at the Luke Celebr we're looking at Celebration Luke Skywalker from the 2009 Lego Star Wars Visual Dictionary. That's what we're looking at next week. And that one will be simple because I'm gonna have to show one picture for that, because like R2-D2, who had to be in 13 sets, and I'm sure he was in a Comic-Con exclusive or something, I don't know. But thanks for watching, like, comment and subscribe. The next video you guys are getting on Tuesday will be the next video you guys are getting on Tuesday is You Asked It, episode 12. I'm gonna be answering more questions. If you've got questions for the 13th episode, which will happen in a few weeks, maybe a month, I actually need to read this a bit better. Comment down below for questions because I answer most questions. But yeah, that'll be the next video. And then obviously next week it's Luke Skywalker Celebration from 2009. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Tell me in the comments what you think of this. Also, my goal of hitting 500 subscribers. We're getting there. We have gotten 3 subscribers since I mentioned that on Tuesday, which is kind of crazy. So 13 more to go. We could be hitting 500 by the end of the month. So thanks for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. Stay tuned for more videos. Bye.